Let's do it, bro. We're back.
Hey, everyone. Welcome to the latest episode of AMD Now Playing. I'm Adit.
And I'm Isaac.
Okay, Isaac. Last time, I had to film this episode alone.
Sorry, bro.
Where were you?
Dude, I've been busy, man. It's been a busy summer. I had a lot of things going on, but I'm back, bro. I got you. The show is going on. So there's been a lot of stuff happening this summer. I haven't come back empty-handed, though. I got a little something for you. Shout out to our friends at Asus for helping me out with this one.
I'm actually really excited. I don't know about this one.
This thing is a beauty, and this is from me to you as a thank you.
Is this the Zephyrus?
This is a Zephyrus G14.
Oh, this is the one from CES.
Unique colorway to the States, actually. Only available in the States in this colorway.
I love how you said this was a gift from you to me, but it's very clearly your name, and I need your password. Oh, it's also your Valorant signed in. Okay, got it. So we'll see whose gift this is after we're done filming.
I was watching Valorant Master Shanghai. I had a grind Valorant Masters. Did I tell you, bro? They recently just reset the ranks. I peaked at Diamond 3. They lowered me all the way down to Silver 1, man. Come on, what's going on?
Were you gaming on this or were you at your desktop at home?
No comment, bro. No comment. I mean, gaming on this thing is a dream. The display is amazing.
This looks OLED, right? Yeah, this will be probably the 8945HS.
Okay.
So that'll be Zen 4, 8 core, 16 threads. And it's like, it's really powerful, like Ryzen AI chip. So this is the one from CES.
Yep.
So, you know, you're getting great performance, great battery life, you know, great efficiency. It's a great laptop. And honestly, I'm really just impressed by this display right now. Definitely OLED. And with OLEDs, the big advantages are, you know, in gaming and multimedia consumption, you know, movies, TV shows, mm-hmm. that kind of stuff. Usually productivity is a little tricky on OLEDs. You get fringing around some of the text. I'm surprised at how little text fringing there is. This is actually a really nice display for an OLED.
This is like Christmas came early or something for Adit.
I might need to benchmark this laptop for a couple weeks.
So yeah, that's been really, really cool. And so yeah, shout out to Asus for this. Yeah, it's really awesome. It's a great machine. It's just on the go, man. It's just gaming on the go, performance on the go. Just really, really cool.
And that's where that Ryzen AI chip's really good, man. That efficiency that you get with those 8040 chips are insane.
I told you, man, we've been up to stuff this summer. Talking about being up to stuff, there's been a great Steam sale as well this summer.
Yes. Okay. So I picked up a bunch of stuff.
Yep.
In terms of the stuff I mostly picked up DLCs.
Okay.
Just for a couple games. Mostly a set of Corsa track packs and some car packs.
Nice.
In terms of games, I didn't actually buy any games for the Steam sale. I did peer pressure some friends, though, into buying some games. I think that's more effective than buying games during the Steam sale.
So what'd they get?
The big game that I got everyone to buy, at least in my circle, Ghost Recon Breakpoint.
Nice. That's a throwback.
Yeah, real throwback. Well, not real throwback, but it's a throwback. Older game. It's probably one of my favorite games from that time period with that generation of consoles. It's just, I always just enjoy, like, just open world PvE games with my friends. And Ghost Recon Breakpoint, you're basically, like, you know, SEAL Team 6. You're just going and, you know, doing all these cool missions. You know, yeah. It's like, you kind of just make your own game and just have fun with your friends. It's pretty cool.
That's awesome.
Yeah. What about you? What are you been playing?
I didn't pick up too much for the Steam sale. I saw my friends, though, have been streaming A Way Out.
Okay.
So I've actually never played A Way Out. But I just love that it's that side-by-side co-op thing. Like, it's similar to It Takes Two.
It was the same studio that made it. Hazelight Studios exactly. Did both of them.
So really, really cool. But in terms of playing actual games, like I told you, I've been playing Valorant, trying to get from Silver 3 back to my Diamond Glory days. but I've also been watching a lot of Valorant as well. Master Shanghai recently ended. And that was just really cool to see the different tactics, lineups. You know, I love my lineups. Yeah, so talking about the best, we've also improved on some technologies here too.
Okay.
I remember earlier in the summer, we were talking about AMD FSR 3.
Yeah.
And now we're already talking about AMD FSR 3.1.
Yeah, so it was a big week for this one.
It's been a huge week. AMD FSR 3.1 is actually now available, and it's available in 5 new titles. Ghost of Tsushima Director's Cut, Horizon Forbidden West, Complete Edition, Marvel's Spider-Man, I know you love that one, Marvel's Spider-Man Miles Morales, as well as Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart. It's also coming soon to God of War Ragnarok.
Oh, really?
So a lot of great titles here. And what's really great too, you were mentioning earlier, you know, you're not just playing on one platform, you're playing on multi-platform.
Yeah, sure. So I've been spending a lot of time on the Ally, on the couch, just watching TV, just really just enjoying it. Like, it's a great handheld, yeah. Right? That's essentially what it's meant for, right?
It's on the go.
Right, it's on the go. So just sit on the couch, watching TV. As soon as this announcement came out for all these games are getting support,
yeah.
The first thing I did was re-download Spider-Man. Yeah, and the results were at the 15-watt mode at medium-ish settings.
Yeah.
With FSR 3 and frame generation, I was sitting around 60 FPS swinging through the city.
You're just comfortable gaming, bro.
I was blown away. I'm just like, you know, my favorite PlayStation 4 game is now just in my pocket. So yep. Last episode, you know, when you weren't here, I mean, I'm going to keep bringing it up. When you weren't here, I talked about Ghost of Tsushima, having FSR and frame generation, and how I was playing it, like, you know, on my desktop, and then I'd bring it over to the couch and play on my Ally. I'm doing the same thing with Spider-Man now, I guess.
And now it's got 3.1. So I got three bullet points to share here about three quick updates for 3.1. FSR 3.1, first of all, has upscaling image quality improvements. So that's a huge bump from the different games that we had before already. The second thing is enhanced FSR 3.1 frame gen. So it's decoupled from our FSR 3 upscaling, and it just adds that extra level of performance.
And what I noticed is too is in Spider-Man, you're actually able to use the in-engine upscaling with FSR's frame generation.
Tell me a little bit more about that. What do you mean by that?
So in the graphic settings, you have obviously all your graphics options. When you get to the upscaling section, you can pick the actual upscaling mode. So you can pick Fidelity Effects, you can pick their in-engine version, and then you have a different toggle for the frame generation.
Oh, no way.
Right, so within frame generation, you can use FSR 3's frame generation, and then you can pick your upscaler and your own scaling values. Okay. Like you get, like again, this pretty is custom. Just... The decision to decouple FSR 3's frame gen from the actual upscaler just gives more opportunities for gamers.
Exactly, man. And so talking about new opportunities, with FSR 3.1, there's a new upgradable FSR API, actually, that's available to game developers. So it just makes it super easy to integrate FSR 3.1 into games. And so the biggest thing, too, gamers can expect 3 times higher frame rates on average with the AMD Radeon RX 7000 series graphics, not just at 1440p gaming, but at 4K gaming as well. Mm-hmm. So super, super exciting. We've talked about FSR 3.1. You've been telling me about gaming on the ROG Ally. Tell me a little bit more about what that's been like for you.
Oh, dude, it's just been fantastic. You know, just, again, just getting, especially with FSR 3 coming to all these games now too, just being able to bring some of like my favorite games that I played like on my PlayStation, like from back in the day, and just throwing in my backpack. And what's nice too is, right, it's like, you know, your saves carry over because, you know, through Steam Cloud Sync or whatever, you know, launcher you're using. Yep. Right, you know, all the controls, they stay the same, like your graphic settings, even when you bounce between, you know, your PC and your Ally, depending on the game, obviously, the graphic settings stay independent depending on the platform.
Man. It makes it easy. So talking about making gaming easy as well, in our latest June driver, 24.6.1, the big thing we want to highlight is our official launch of Anti-Lag 2. Mm-hmm. So before, when you wanted to use Anti-Lag 2, you had to download it from a technical preview driver. Now it's a full launch in our latest driver. So all you got to do is go to your driver and make sure you hit update and install, and you'll have Anti-Lag 2 on the latest supported titles. One of those titles, like you mentioned, being CS2. So now when I'm queuing with you, you know, other people or we cannot blame, you know, our gaming on the mouse latency. Cool. There's been so much great stuff that we've talked about. I'm so glad to be back here with you, man. You won't be alone anymore. And until next time, anything to say to the viewers?
No, it's been fantastic to have you back on set.
And, thank you, man.
You know, talking games. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoy the video. And Isaac?
Leave a comment down below in terms of what you loved, what you want us to cover next, who you want us to partner next. We recently hit 34K subs, and we're really trying to hit maybe that even 50K sub number by the end of the summer. And so continue to help us out with that. And until then, we'll see you on the next episode of AMD Now Playing.